Mae Smith with the Arizona Humane Society is here with Little Buzz. And it's interesting. You guys at Arizona Humane Society have so many opportunities for us to bring our pets in and to teach them things.
Yes.
That, Danae, you brought Buzz in to tell us about the Sense and Activities class. What is that class?
Yes, it's one of my favorites and really a way to interact with your dog and bond with them in a different way.
Buzz knows where the treats are.
He smells them for sure. So this class is basically, we're teaching our dog how to find a scent. And today we'll show it a little bit later how he can do it at kind of a beginner level and how we start you out. And the class will just build you up. It's a great way for your dog to get mental exercise, physical exercise, and like I said, just that bonding experience with your pet.
Now, what kind of dog is Buzz?
Buzz is an Australian cattle dog. He's about 3 months old.
Okay, and earlier everyone in the studio was freaking out about how this particular breed has a really, you know, a good reputation for being very smart, picking things up really quickly. Is there a certain breed that's, you know, right for this class or wrong for this class?
I don't necessarily think so. I think all of our dogs are going to have incredible senses of smell. Obviously, a bloodhound is going to have, you know, a stronger sense of smell. But even something like a pug, a bulldog, a chihuahua, they would all be very happy doing this.
So other than just, you know, like exercising their brain and, of course, their body, too, what are some of the benefits of taking this class?
So this is a great way, especially during the summer when it's so hot out and you can't get out quite as much. You know, release some of that energy, and it teaches you how to do it. Take it home. You can do it in your own backyard. And just kind of bond with your dog in a way that they're having fun, and they don't have to work in the way like obedience does. Like doing all those sits, they get to enjoy themselves, and you get to see that side of them a little bit more.
So let's see a little bit of what this Sense and Activities training would be like if you brought your pup in. Like,
sure.
Buzz, our faithful friend here, is ready to go. As you can see, we probably have to have a lot of treats on hand for this training.
Yes, for sure. We would definitely have fun. We've got some really stinky treats. They're beef jerky, so we want him to be able to find them a little bit easier today. If you want to hang on to his leash, I'm just going to load up, and he's going to find the correct box that the treats are in.
Okay.
All right, so let's hide him.
Emma, how do you do without him?
Because
he just went. He was like, I found it.
We'll mix up these
Come
boxes.
Here, Buzzy.
Look at that one.
What's that, Buzzy?
One. Or this one. Okay, now ready? Buzz, search.
Buzz is like, easy peasy.
Yes.
I love, and normally in the training, do you take the dogs out of the room or do you hide their eyes somehow? Because, I mean, like, Buzz got to see the answer.
Yeah, right. He's still going at it. They would ideally be at a little bit farther distance, so I'm not necessarily going to hide anything at this level, but you can get to that level for sure. We start off with our boxes really close, and then progressively we try to spread them out more and more, so the challenge increases as we go on.
I could see at home this could keep them busy for quite some time, depending on what you put the treats in.
Right? You could even do this with, like, their meals, their breakfast or their dinner, and have them work for some of their food during the day.
Oh, that's interesting. So what other kind of classes do you guys have? You mentioned obedience training.
Yeah, so we have a few different obedience classes.
Good.
Ranges from basics, intermediate, advanced. We're going to teach your dog, you know, how to be well-behaved when guests come over, how to meet people on the street, prepare you for canine good citizen testing.
And what are we seeing here? Is this like just getting to know animals, getting to know each other?
A little bit. So this is called our puppy party. So our dog's under 6 months of age, and they basically just get that socialization time that they really need as puppies. One of my favorite times of the week is holding puppy party.
So my dog just turned one, and I feel like I did a disservice to her because I didn't do things like this, and so now she's already very timid with dogs, but she's past that 6 months age. So do you just recommend, like, you know, taking her to the dog park more, or is there?
Yeah, you could even just start off with, like I said, like a basics class, or we have an excellent class called Reactive Rover that can help de-stress seeing other dogs and stuff like that in a nice way where we can, you know, provide treats and make it a more positive experience so they don't get so scared.
Absolutely. Now, Buzz is adorable, and I know you guys have so many pets, so many furry friends up for adoption.
Yes.
And where do we get the information on these classes and where to get pups like Buzz
here? So you
can
see all of our pups online at our website at azhumane.org. Under adoption, there's cat adoptions, dog adoptions, and you might even find some little furry critters. For dog training classes, you'd go to azhumane.org/training and see our big list of classes and like puppy party or scent games. Those will be listed under our specialty sections.
You've got us covered all the way from bringing your furry friend home to keeping them trained and entertained. Thank you so much, Danae. If you want more information on the Arizona Humane Society, connect with us on Facebook.